So there's the beast and the grizzly. I don't think the beast has moved since Christmas. I took the grizzly out maybe mid-May with Team Mud Pro for a ride, but that's about it. There they sit, all covered up. Hello everybody. June 28th, our Canada Day long weekend. And it's CK here and I'm out on the Kodiak. Ooh, haven't been down this little steep hill for a while. Whoa. Lean, there we go. Whew. That was a little bit challenging. So I don't really know where I'm going. I'm just kind of out for a little ride today. I know you guys haven't heard from us in a pretty long time. Cubby and I wanted to give everybody a little bit of an update about what's going on, and I thought I'd do that while I went out for a little ride. So Cubby and I haven't been out riding together for ages, it seems, just because he's been sick and not feeling up to it. I did get to go out with Team Mud Pro maybe about mid-May, I guess, and did some exploring around Area 52, which was really nice. And the Kodiak doesn't get used all that much, so figured it'd be good to take it out. Can't believe how dry it is back here. This usually is just so swampy and full of water. And look, there's hardly any water in there. Oh, I should shift this to low, I think. Look at how tall the grass is. It's taller than the Kodiak. We've been walking back here a little bit. Earlier in the year, we got to see, well, maybe about a month ago, little baby fawn. There's a few does around and they've been having their little babies, so that was pretty cool to see. Should have a clip of it right here. Hey, big mama. Are you being a good mama? So there's this new little baby fawn. Walking in the back and staying safe in the long grass. June 1st. Oh, so sweet. It's okay, baby. Walking on the way back, we see another baby. Do here. There's a big tree down. Huh. I'm gonna have to find an alternate route. Alright, well, I assessed the situation, and although the trail actually goes that way, I can see there's an old trail this way, so I'm thinking this is gonna work and get me around that big tree. As even if I had the power saw with me, I don't think I'd be using it. And so, as some of you guys know, Cubby's been sick now for, geez, almost about 3 years coming up, I think. And at first he was tested for all kinds of things, and doctors couldn't figure out what was wrong with him, and wasn't too bad for a while, and then probably about late last fall, early this year, he started getting a lot worse, and we knew we were going to have to do something, so we took matters into our own hands and did a bunch of research, and the more we read and the more we heard people talk, we just figured that it was a really good chance it had to be Lyme, because what else could it be? So we found a tick doctor, well, not actually a tick doctor, a Lyme specialist, I guess. So the doctor was really helpful. He had Cubby's blood sent away to a German lab where it was tested for all kinds of things. And about a month ago, the results came back definitively 100% Cubby has Lyme, along with some bacterial and viral co-infections. So that would explain all the symptoms and why he wasn't getting any better. So at least we know now what we're dealing with. So we're just starting the treatment phase, and we're finding in Ontario it's not that easy to get the appropriate antibiotic treatment for chronic Lyme. But we finally started making some progress. He's taking antibiotics and some natural medication. He's actually taking about 60 different pills a day. Well, some of that's liquid, but you kind of get the idea. So hopefully all this treatment's gonna work and get Cubby feeling better here pretty quick. It's 3 days in and so far so good. Nothing's fallen off him yet. He's pretty happy about that. Well, me too, actually. And it's amazing, all the different medication, nothing seems to be interacting with anything. So we're also really happy with that. So some of you may recognize this sketchy bridge from some of our pictures that we post. Definitely sketchy. Looks like somebody's brought some new pallets here. Maybe they're gonna try to resurface it. I don't know though, those supports don't look overly good, so even if they do get it across the top, I don't think I'll be the first one taking a four-wheeler over there, that's for sure. I can walk across it now, but a little different with a four-wheeler. I'm gonna be brave here and check this out a little bit better. I don't really want to go for a swim though, that water's looking pretty stagnant. It's clear though. See, there's parts of the old bridge down there. Be good if it was a good bridge. So I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everybody, all the viewers, all the partners, all the Patreons. Big thanks to Team Mud Pro. We don't know how long treatment's gonna take. We think Cubby might have had this for a number of years, and again, it's a bit of a journey, and we hope to be back making videos, but we really don't know when, so not sure if you're gonna see any more from us, at least in the near future after this one. Keep checking back on the channel though, and we try to post updates on Facebook and Instagram and keep sharing pictures. So if you're wondering how things are going, you can always check those out. Cubby made this cool new t-shirt design about just say no to ticks and tick check with a friend, because you don't want this. Definitely if you're out in the woods, checking for ticks is so important. Hate for anybody else to get this disease, that's for sure. Oh, I haven't been down here in a long time. Huh, that tree died. Wonder if I'm gonna see any deer. Ooh, look at those pretty flowers. I think I should shift to high here. Oh, I'm in high. Huh, okay. Just need to give it more throttle. Oh, I knew there was a hole there somewhere. Whee! Well, you might hear things rattling around. I have a bottle of water and some bug spray in the back, and every time I hit a bump, it makes a big clunk. So Cubby had talked about shutting the channel down just because we didn't have any new content to put out, and I've talked him out of that for now, so hopefully we're gonna get him feeling better here. Sounds like though treatment can be 6 months to a year, provided everything goes well, so like I said, I don't know when we'll be back. We really wanna be, and want to get back outdoors and doing the things we love to do. So hopefully we'll be able to do that sooner than later. Ooh, groundhog. Hey. I was coming to check these burrows. I didn't know if they'd be here or not. You have to make sure you don't hit those when you're four-wheeling. We've almost gone over the bars a few times.
She's staying so still. That's the burrow, I guess. She's probably standing right underneath me. I think we put a GoPro down there once. Didn't see anything, but... here's the Kodiak.
So you probably can't see way over there because in the GoPro, again, it's going to look like a little postage stamp, but I think that's a deer.
I just saw this big hawk fly into that tree there. Can't really zoom in very much with this iPhone, but it's not too bad. I don't know what he's doing there. Probably hunting for mice or something.
So there's the update we wanted to give everybody. Kind of tell you what's going on in our world at the moment. Focused on getting Cubbee healthy again, so hopefully we can get out back riding and making more videos. So until next time, thanks for watching, everybody.